ஸ்ரீகிருஷ்ணா 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 ஸ்ரீகிருஷ்ணா. குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர குரு சாட்சாத் பரம் பிரம்ம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம. அத்யாத்மோபனிஷத். ஒன் இஸ் அத்யாத்மா, செகண்ட் இஸ் அதிதைவ, தேர்ட் இஸ் அதிபூத. தேர்ஃபோர் ஆஃப்டர் எவ்ரி மந்திர வி சாண்ட் ஓம் சாந்தி சாந்தி சாந்தி. தீஸ் த்ரீ சாந்திஸ் ஆர் அட்ரெஸிங் டு தீஸ் த்ரீ காம்போனன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் our life. One component of our life is adibhuta. Adibhuta means this gross world where we are supposed to enjoy or suffer. This gross world. And we enjoy or suffer with reference to gross world by possessions. We want to possess the things. And our whole life thereafter goes only in accumulating possessions. See? And whatever is recognized by us as infinite, we don't think of possession. See? For example, if you see a beautiful picture in some art gallery, one of my friend, she is having art gallery in Bangalore, and she took me to her art gallery. I said, hey, come on, there is nobody. What kind of gallery you have? He says, Swamiji, in our art gallery, people can visit only by appointment. Anybody just can't walk in. Wow, is it a hospital or a dentist shop? He said, no. People are those who are interested. To them only we allow. I said, okay. So she showed me. And I saw all kinds of pictures. Then she said, this is our lowest category of pictures. Lowest category. Can you imagine how much it will cost? I said, maybe 200-300 rupees, 500 maximum. She says, Swamiji, the lowest category costs between 5 and 10 lakhs. I said, my BP is increasing. And then, what is the highest category? So she took me to the third floor. And she showed few of them. Not too many, maybe about 30-40 only. All displayed properly with the light and every effect. I said, how much this much? How will this much cost? She said, not much, Swamiji. This is not much. How much? Each one of will be between 3 to 5 crores. Anything which is finite, you want to possess. Now we are sitting in front of this nature. Do we think, I wish I can take the whole thing at home? Where will you keep it? See, this one principle, where will you keep it, is such a beautiful principle which will discover dispassion in your heart without any efforts. See? For example, in Nagpur, I think, I went to somebody's house. Those people are associated with Haldiram products, owners, and very good people. So, after everything was over, he has presented me a huge picture, well framed nicely. Picture with the golden plating. See, must be costing quite a big amount, gold plating. So, after he gave me, I said, hey, so beautiful, so nice. And they had one daughter-in-law. So I said, hey, come here. I haven't brought anything. I didn't know I am going to see you. And for the first time, when you see a daughter-in-law, you are supposed to give her something. So I give you this picture. Now the father-in-law says, Swamiji, I gave it to you. I said, you didn't give it to me. No, I gave it to you. I said, then what right you have on this picture? I can do anything I like. I can throw it in the garbage. No, I wanted you to keep it in your room. I said, very good. Along with this picture, you have to give me a house. Then I can fix it. When you know all these possessions are merely a burden on our head, the real spiritual practice begins. Adi Bhautik. World will lose its sway on our mind. Now I am sure Bharat Bhai must have planned your shopping spree here. And you will carry all the garbage. And then they are called as discussion pieces. So this one, when I went to Sri Lanka, Ravana invited me. And we did making memory and possessions, that becomes our I. How simple it is. That is Adi Bhautik area. Most of us are lost in this Adi Bhautik world. Then the second one is Adi Daivik area. We are studying Adhyatma. What is Adi Daivik? Adi Daivik is with reference to our struggle to fulfill our desires, which we cannot fulfill by the Adi Bhautik sources. Then we want to invoke some higher powers. There is one lady, now she is pretty old, her children are grown up, cross teenage. When she got married, so she asked me, Swamiji, please give me some advice. I said, immediately, within 1 or 2 years, you must have 2-3 kids. That is my advice. No Gita, no Upanishad, no nothing. Have bachcha. So she said, Swamiji, I said, you discuss. I don't like anybody discussing anything with me. You take it or throw it. I don't care. Then her husband said, who is this Swamiji to meddle in our life? We won't have children for 5 years. We want to enjoy life. She said, you may say anything. For me, my Swami's words are last. I became a Gabbar Singh in their family. I became a great villain. But by God's grace, a baby was born within 2 years. Thereafter, that same man who was cursing me, he came and told me, Swamiji, I am sorry I spoke all ill about you to my wife, but today I understand. I kept quiet. Why should I? Why you, what you understood? He said, now I know. I got many friends who had the same philosophy like mine. Why should we have children so early? We will have it later, maybe after 5-7 years. Now in young age, we must enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. So they have been enjoying, enjoying, enjoying. And after 5-6 years, no kids. Everything is normal, but no kids. So all doctors give the right report, everything is done, but no kids. Now what is to be done, what is to be done? Then Adi Daivik. Go to Satya Sai Baba, go to Shirdi Baba, go to this temple, go to that temple and do pradakshina and do upavas and all kinds of things. So that which cannot be achieved by the Adi Bhautik techniques, we start invoking Adi Daivik techniques. See friends, and such Mahatmas who have invoked this infinite power in him or her, they have that ability to change the course of life. by blessing or by cursing. And you will see around such Mahatmas, there will be huge crowds. Because for us, what is life? Life is only fulfilling the desires, nothing else. In one house, I think I told somewhere recently, that she was a teacher, and when I was staying with them, one big bundle of answer books came, and she was supposed to correct them and send it to the board. So one answer book was having all the pages, Om Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram Jai Jai, nothing else. And at the end, I have not studied, but by God's grace, anything can happen. You please pass me, dear, who's your unit? Adi Daivik. So, that teacher, Swamiji, what should I do? I failed this fellow. This is not the answer. See, friends, we want always something to happen for what we don't deserve. And then these Adi Daivik powers are involved. See, if you read most of the stotras, it is said at the end Parashruti. If you chant this thing, if you don't have money, you will get money. If you are married, you will get divorce. Like that, one after another. So, the only purpose is to fulfill our desires, which cannot be fulfilled by the Adi Bhautik, by the material ways. Then we invoke the divine ways. Such people and such gatherings are the hospitals. See? When we go to the hospital, our disease or whatever problem is there is sorted out. Thereafter, do we go again to the doctor? Daksha, pranam, namaskar. No. After our job is over, who cares? And if the job is not done properly, we sue him in the court. Therefore, Adi Daivik is also samsara. And this Adi Daivik is very clearly indicated in the Puranic stories. The purpose of this Adi Daivik is not understood, therefore people get lost only in that. And what is the main theme of the stories? Some Mahatma was insulted, he became angry, he cursed, and that person was destroyed. That person had nothing, and therefore he prayed the Mahatma, and he blessed, and he got everything. So only fulfilling the desires is the only story that these people have. And everywhere there is some chamatkar. Things which cannot happen in Adi Bhautik, they start happening in Adi Daivik. If you take Draupadi, she was not born like you and me are born. She was born out of Agni Kunda. Her father, the king, he did some kind of ahuti tapasya, and from the fire she was born. And she had always fragrance to her whole body. We have got perspiration. And all the six Pandavas, from Karna onwards, all of them were born out of the Mantra Shakti. See, this is all Adi Daivik. And in Yoga Shastra, there are mantras which tell that when you invoke this inner potentiality in you through proper practices, one can go to an extent that as the ladies make different dishes out of the same stuff. Stuff is the same, but they know how to fool the person who is eating. One day I went to somebody's house for very late, at about 12:30 or 1 o'clock. Late flight, whatever. Then after reaching, I said, Mama, I am very hungry. please give me something to eat. So she said, okay, Swamiji, sit down, I'll just prepare something fresh. I said, no fresh, give anything either. No, no, 10 minutes you give me. And there were 3-4 sabjis, dal, chapati, rice. Her husband says, see Swamiji, for you, so many things are prepared. In no time, I never get this thing. I said, look here, you can be fooled, I cannot be fooled. I said, these 3 sabjis, they look, they are the same. Toppings are different. On one there is coconut powder. Another there is, you know, that dhaniya. And third there is little bit of dahi. It looks different, but inside substratum is one. So how these ladies can make so many things out of the same stuff? These great yogis, they can mix these 5 elements and they can make anything out of it, sentient or insentient. Those siddhis are there. They are adhidaivik. And then we come to the third, adhyatmik. In adhyatmik, only that person is qualified who has risen above the adhibhautik and adhidaivik. So in adhibhautik, maximum number is involved, whole world. Then you come to adhidaivik, the pyramid starts tapering, lesser as compared to the gross worldly people. And at that big, the tip of the pyramid, hardly there is anybody there. Like in the KG1, KG2 primary, thousands and thousands and millions of children. Go to the high school, number is reduced. Go for the doctorate, hardly there is anybody. Because who wants the truth? There was a great master in Ganeshpuri near Mumbai, Nityananda Baba. Completely charcoal black, huge, only with the lion cloth. And he used to say, I am here to sell diamonds. First Hindi words I will tell you, then I will tell in English. I am here to sell hira, but people ask for hing. I am here to give the diamond, but the people are asking for asafoetida. Nobody wants. Who wants the truth? Therefore, Adhyatma Shastra is that when we have withdrawn from the gross world, first step. And withdrawal from the gross world is only when we are not or no more identified with our gross body. Otherwise, many places they have, you know, these dynamic meditations. Very good friends of mine, they always invite me. And when they will have these meditations wherein they'll be dancing, ha, hoo, ha, singing and all. Ha, and after that, exhaustion. Maja aa gaya, maja aa gaya. It is something like eat up to the nose. Ha, it was very good, but now I have to sleep. That dynamic meditation, etc., it is only the physical itch. Is only the khujli, nothing else. It is only at the matter level, far away from the truth. See? Therefore, first we have to rise above the body identification. Then the second, adhidaivik, is functioning at the level of the mind. Then all of us got only one complaint. There are too many thoughts in the mind. This is the basic error. Should we go to the doctor and say, Doctor Saab, when I open my eyes, I can see everything very good? No. When we go to the ENT specialist, and should we say, when my ears are open, I can hear everything perfectly well? Why do you come? Similarly, if there are thoughts in the mind, now where the thought should come? In the nose. What thoughts thrown? Thoughts have to come in the mind. If the thoughts don't come in the mind, where will they go? See, friends. So what they tell, mind should be free from thoughts. Why free from thoughts? No. Let the thoughts come. Who cares? In Cochin, many years before, I went from a very long journey. Maybe at about 12:30, 1 o'clock. And Cochin means Kerala. Kerala means dosha. They knew I like rava dosha. So, dosha was made. And what is the best dosha? That dosha is best while eating you feel sleepy. It is highly alcoholic. So I ate nicely, 2-3 of them, and slept. And in between, that boy will come and say, Swamiji, we have announced your lecture, but people are asking, what is the topic? What is the topic? And I'm sleeping, man. I said, come on, who cares? Then again I slept. He put the topic, who cares? Swamiji is going to talk on who cares. That day I got this mantra in my life, who cares? Who cares means you are totally indifferent. So when we learn this basic, that if there are thoughts in the mind, never mind, let them come and go. And instead of complaining, there are too many thoughts in our mind, now start working. To whom the thoughts come? If there is a mango tree, there won't be pineapples hanging over there. There will be mangoes only. Like yesterday I told you, some people met me on seaside in Bombay. He said, Swamiji, your one mantra has really helped, such a best mantra in life. Whenever you are miserable, find out who is miserable. You will come to know husband is miserable. Then you find out, you are a husband or a man. You decide. Man, you are 24/7. Husband, you are only in a condition. When you are imprisoned, you are a husband. When you are away from the wife, you are a man. So learn to be away from the wife when she is nearer you. How? Don't take her seriously. The moment you take this approach in your life, mind will never be an issue. But what happens? We are obstinate. When I sit for meditation, there should not be thoughts. Mind says, why not? Am I angry? It is like the indisciplined child. Otherwise, the child is normal. The moment some visitors come, something happens to that child. And the child starts seeking attention from everybody in the family. So he will try to be goody-goody. If you don't listen to him, then he will start throwing tantrums and wham, wham, wham. And somehow or the other, he wants attention. Exactly the same way, the mind is constantly seeking attention. The more you press it, no thoughts. Why not? And their whole meditation is Chitta Vritti Nirodha Yoga. The basic error they don't correct. No thought can come without words. No yogi will tell you this. They only tell, don't think. Now try this. Try to think without using any word. Then what to think? Immediately the mind becomes frustrated. This is a simple thing. When we come out of our house, We come out after putting on clothes. We don't come out naked. Exactly the same way. The thoughts come out of the mind after putting the clothes of words. That is what we have been telling you again and again. Try this. Stop talking to yourself. Instead of understanding this, chitta vritti nirodha yoga. And become more and more miserable. See? So this adhi daivik is a total tragedy when functioning in the outer world, getting lost in the possessions. And those possessions are stored where? In our mind. We don't store the whole house inside the body. It is only the memory or the image of that possessiveness is on the mind. The outer world keeps on accumulating in the mind, and inner world is full of desires. And the one who desires, he is somebody. So now there are two things happening. One, who is possessor of the possessions? And second one is the desirer of the desires. These two things put together is Mr. Somebody. At the root of every thought, there is somebody. Nobody has no thoughts. Somebody will have some thoughts. Therefore, in the morning meditation class, we told you the psychological adjustments, Mr. Nobody. And nobody cannot have any thoughts. And even if the thoughts come, immediately find out to whom the thoughts have come. Oh, it is the grandmother. Why? Thinking about whether the grandchild is taken to potty or still carrying with him. Where is meditation? Where is potty? It is so simple, friends. When we thus graduate from the adhi bhautik and adhi daivik, then we enter adhyatma. And this is what we all do. But when it is done without knowledge, it goes waste. There was a Guru Maharaj, he gave one piece of a bright shining stone kind of thing to the disciple. Go and see how much you can sell it, but don't sell it, bring it back. So he went to few shops and said, somebody said 100 rupees, somebody said 500 rupees, somebody said 1000 rupees. Okay. Go to the jeweler. So the jeweler saw, he said, okay, I'll give you 100,000 rupees. He said, okay. No, but I cannot give you, I just wanted to know value of it. Peace is the same. The one who knows, he has a value of it. The one who doesn't know, he has no value. In the same manner, adi bhautik, adi daivik and adhyatmik. What value we have. Those who have spent their life in selling vegetables, they can never know what is the joy in selling a diamond piece. In the same manner, those who have spent their whole life only in this adi bhautik world or adi daivik world, blessing the people and cursing the people. Wherever this kind of blessing and cursing goes on, it is adi daivik. See, these curses are called in Sanskrit as shap. So such mahatmas are mobile shopping centers. Go on cursing somebody. If you do this, it happens also. But that is not a spiritual life. And therefore, such as you are all are now qualified for Adhyatma Upanishad. Swamiji, so are we? Yes. Otherwise, why will you come here all the way? Knowing well that this Swamiji talks nothing except two things. Give up the body identification, give up the jiva bhav. And again the same thing, vai tamako, vai chuna, ragdor ka. See, friends, there was one story I read about Guru Nanak Dev Maharaj. He was illiterate. He also belongs to the same Adidaivik area. So, he was not studying and all that. And then he was asked to go and do the gardening. So, he was picking up the rice and lift it and fix it. So he was told, lift it from here and put it there, in their local language. So he was doing it 1, 2, 3, 4, and when it came to Tera, he stopped. He said, well, now what next? Tera, everything is over. For us, Tera, it's an inauspicious figure. Word is the same. What meaning we get? Therefore, when we are thus contemplative, immediately the Adi Bhautik, Adi Daivik world disappears, and then we come to know the real spiritual life begins when the inquiry kindles. Inquiry is different from complaints. 99% questions are complaints. So, Adhyatma Upanishad we begin. If you like, you can repeat after me. If you don't like or if you cannot, simply pretend you are chanting. This is what most of the people do, I know that. So instead of you feeling guilty, I have no objection. Try. Antashareere nihito guhayam. Aja eko nityamasya. Prithivi shariram. Yaha prithivi mantare sancharan. Yam prithivi na veda. Yasyapaha shariram. Yo apontare sancharan. Yamapona viduhu. Yasya tejaha shariram. Yastejontare sancharan. Yam tejona veda. Yasya vayuhu shariram. Yo vayumantare sancharan. Yam vayurna veda. Yasya akashaha shariram. Ya akashantare sancharan. Yamakasho na veda. Yasya manaha shariram. Yo manontare sancharan. Yam mano na veda. Yasya buddhihi shariram. Yo buddhimantare sancharan. Yam buddhirna vidu veda. Yasya hankara shariram. Yo hankara mantare sancharan. Yam ahankaro na veda. Yasya chittam shariram. Yaschittamantare sancharan. Tam chittam yam chittam na veda. Yasya avyaktam shariram. Yo avyaktamantare sancharan. Yam avyaktam na veda. यस्याक्षरं शरीरं यो अक्षरमन्तरे सञ्चरन् यमक्षरं न वेद यस्य मृत्युः शरीरं यो मृत्युमन्तरे सञ्चरन् यं मृत्युर्न वेद स एष सर्वभूतान्तरात्मा अपहत पाप्मा दिव्यो देव एको नारायणः अहं ममेति यो भावो देहाक्षादावनात्मनि अध्यासोऽयं निरस्तव्यो विदुषा ब्रह्मनिष्ठया. Now this chanting will take away the sleep. You know what happens in bhajan kirtan when the pravachankar sees that the people are feeling drowsy after the breakfast. It is easier to do operation of the brain. I have seen the operation of the brain. The person is never put into anesthesia when they do operation on brain. Because brain has no sensation. Brain is senseless, like us. It is easier, that operation, than the operation working on the mind, which is constantly running here and there to catch the mind and to put the things inside. Because when the mind will switch off, or the mind runs here and there. And when some joke happens, everybody is laughing. And this fellow had gone for shopping. And then he said, hey, what happened? What happened? Then he was told again the same joke. And then he laughed. Late. So, if you see, there is something which is again and again repeated. This is called as abhyas. When something is again and again repeated, at least out of so many, at least one will click. See? If you have to throw one stone at one pillar, chances are you will miss it. Then what is to be done? Take a handful of stones and throw at least one will hit. That is what is Vishnu Sahasranam. Keep on chanting, Vishnu, Vishnu, Shatkaro, Bhuta, at least one will eat. And Lord Shiva tells Parvati ji, Rama Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Manorame Sahasranama Tatulyam Rama Nama Varanane. But if you take only once Rama Nam with complete involvement, fully, is equivalent to 1,000 names of Vishnu. Therefore, average people are given Vishnu Sahasranam. Maro ek to lagega. So here also abhyasa. What is said here? Asya prithivi shariram yaha prithivi antare sancharan. Then apaha shariram apo antare sancharan. Tejaha shariram tejo antare sancharan. Vayuhu shariram vayu antare sancharan. Akasha shariram akashe antaram sancharan. Then manaha shariram mano antare sancharan. Buddhi shariram buddhi antare sancharan. Ahankara shariram ahankara antare shariram. Chitta chittam shariram chittam antare sancharan. Avyakta shariram avyaktam antare sancharan. Aksharam shariram aksharam antare sancharam. Mrityuhu shariram mrityum antare sancharan. Meaning, the same reality is expressing through all this. To understand this, take simple example, day-to-day example. Yaha, that, in place of yaha, that keep electricity. Yaha, balba antare sancharan, balbam na veda. Yaha, fan antare sancharan, Fanam Naveda. But can the fan work without electricity? Can the bulb work without electricity? Our whole life is a struggle to know the truth through the sense organs, organs of action, mind, etc. How simple the mantra is. So, antaha sharire nihito guhayam. There is but one reality. And that one reality is sharire, in the body. It is never said in my body. Mama dehe, it is not said. Sharire, in everybody. See. So, anta sharire nihito guhaya. In the guha. Guha means a Bengali. Bengalis are a guha. Guha normally is taken as the intellect. But the truth is, guha is a cave, and the cave hides something which is covered by the cave. See? So, the Annamaya Kosha is one covering of the gufa or the guha or the cave. Then the second one is the Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, then Anandamaya Kosha, then Avyakta, Akshara. Therefore, you will see many people have got this notion, particularly yogis and all that. There was one student, he came and asked me, Swamiji, I want to go to Himalayas for doing meditation in gufa. Why they want to go to, you know, that gufa? Because most of the students walking spiritual path, they have one day or the other read that book, Autobiography of a Yogi. You cannot go without reading that book. And in that book, there are all magical things happening. And then that Mahatmaji Lahari Mahashaya was told that you were doing meditation in the last life. And then he is doing meditation there. So these novice, they also want to go and do meditation in the gufa. So this student came and asked me, I said, look here, before going to Himalayas, come to Lonavala. There is area called as Karla, one small village, and there are many mountains around. And there are many caves which are freely available, you don't have to pay. And near one temple also there are caves, you go to the temple, and Panditji, you refer my name or I can give you sleep, and he will allow you. So he went there. Evening 5 o'clock, when the sun sets, Panditji locked that Devi inside. Devi may run away. So he locked inside and he came down. And this man wanted to sit in meditation in the gufa. Little bit darkness, all the cricket started making noise. No bathroom, no toilet, no AC, no DC, no nothing. And then he said, my God, how am I going to stay here for the whole night? I think something is wrong. He came down. Next day he said, Swamiji, it was terrible. There is nothing there. I don't know how people were staying in gufa. I said, I can tell you. When you go home, go via a shop of an artist and get written on a nice board, framed beautifully, designs and all that, flowers and everything. Cave, C-A-V-E. And fix that board on the door of your room. Go out. And come, look at, oh, this is a cave. And enter, close the room and relax. Cave is not a physical structure. See, friends, cave is these panchakoshas. And these panchakoshas are one cave. The second cave is these five great elements. And panchakoshas are nothing but the product of the five great elements. See, sattva-guna aspect of the five elements become the knowledge aspect of our personality. The tamo-guna aspect of the five elements becomes our gross body. And the rajo-guna aspect of the five elements becomes the power, the organs of action, prana, etc. So the pancha mahabhutas are the material cause and our pancha koshas are the effect. So they are the cause and our individual body is the effect. And all of them are supported by the same reality. Now why we are not able to comprehend that is because we have got some peculiar funny notions about the truth. One notion is, wherever there is life, God is there. No, God is whether there is life or death. Therefore, it is very clearly said, yaha mrityumantare sancharan, mrityur naveda. The one which supports the death. So Paramatma is beyond the life and death. See, friends, normally we get lost only this. Oh, God came and he went. After that I am very miserable. Not only you, God is also miserable. Why did I go? All the wrong notions are hammered without creating any new notion. If you want to know the space, what you have to do? Delete all the contents of the space. In one research organization, military defense research organization, they took me in Delhi many years before. And he showed me, Swamiji, see, I'll explain you. And he explained everything. See, when I phone from here, my sound waves will go to the satellite and from there it will come to you. And it is so fast, although the distance is in so many miles and miles away. He explained everything. Being a military officer, a standard question. Do you have any doubts? So I asked him, what is the name of your organization? He thought, what dumb question this Swami has asked. This is a Defense Space Research Center. I said, if there is a center, Potato Research Center, you have to define potato, is it? You cannot take the eggplants for conducting research. This is not potato, yaar. There are potatoes inside. I am very familiar with it. So when you are telling Space Research Center, define space. What you are talking about? The contents of the space, the satellite. See? You don't talk about space. Then further, we get lost only in the directions. North, east, west, south. Swamiji, that temple's face should be this side or that side. No, it should be inside. One student infected with Vedanta, he was asked by the teacher, what are the different states of matter? He said, Jagra, Swapna, Sushupti, waking, dream and deep sleep state, or liquid, solids and gaseous. So whether the world we take or ourselves we take, everything is supported by the same reality. Meaning what? Everything in this world is hiding the reality. Covered means hiding the reality. Like, space is covered by the contents. Our attention is to the contents, not to the space. In one children's camp or somewhere, I was talking to the children. Swamiji, how to explain the five great elements to the children? Some children's teacher, she asked me, I said, okay, I'll teach. Then I took soil, see, this is element earth. Understood? Yes, they understood everything. And when I went for breakfast, one of the child from that house has come. So the mother said, you went for Swamiji's lectures, what did you learn today in your school? What Swamiji taught? Mommy, come, I'll teach you. Very easy. He took the soil and spread it on the dining table. This is earth. He took that glass of water, spilled everything. This is water. Then he went to the kitchen and he said, that one, what are you firing? You know, the flame coming out of the gas, that is fire element. Air, come here. And he, like on her face, do you feel something? Yes, that is air. Then came the space. Now space. Swamiji, thank God you are here. Will you please do like this? I said, why? You do like this? I said, okay. Then he told, Mommy, that in between Swamiji's finger is space. So for him, only that which is in between my finger is the space. If it is in between your fingers, it's not a space. Exactly the same way. Our knowledge about the self is covered by the contents. And therefore, we do not know the container. So, we are clouded, conditioned by the directions. North, east, west, south. Then, feng shui. One infection. Second is, what do you call that? Vastu Shastra. Third one is graha. This graha has come, this has gone. And you are still there, you also go. See, friends, these things become so powerful that they cover the reality. See? The other day I was sitting like this, very clean sky. So, my friend asked me, Swamiji, what are you looking? I said, I am not looking anything. No, but you must be doing something. You are like that. I said, okay, tell me what is the blue color of the sky? What are you seeing? The blue sky. Very good. Now, what is the blue sky? He said, Swamiji, it is optical illusion. I said, very good. It's optical illusion. Where are the clouds? Clouds are in the optical illusion. Where is this world? The world is an optical illusion. And yet the world is real. Why you think like this, Swamiji? I said, it's a manufacturer's defect. See, my friends, when your vision changes, the perceptions are different. When a glutton like me goes, interested only in eating, so he will simply think of eat and forget. But if a businessman goes, he will eat also and immediately start planning, okay, if I take it to my shop, if I sell it here, I will get this much profit. So that object is forgotten because something is covering it. See. And how the five great elements cover the truth? Because we are the slaves of the five objects, Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, through our five sense organs. Now be attentive. This example which I am telling you, I have given it 2-3 times, but it's a very deep example. Try to catch it, the real import. In Delhi it happened, a good friend of mine is a police officer. One day he came and he said, Swamiji, I couldn't come this year because I was extremely busy with so many things. So I just came to take your darshan. And standing in the, it was 8-9 o'clock at night, and near the door, give me something which will keep me busy for the whole year. I told him this simple technique. I said, ready? He said, yes. I said, switch off the lights. He switched off. Now what are you seeing? He said, nothing, only darkness. Anything more? No. Very good. Now switch on the lights, he switched on. Now what are you seeing? He told all the contents of the room. I am seeing you, your table, your laptop, your water bottle, your shoes, everything. Very good. I said, but I am seeing something more than this. What more? I said, I am seeing the light. Without the light, can you see these things? Not only that, I am seeing electricity. Can there be light without electricity? But what is happening to you? The worldly objects are covering the light. The light is covering the electricity. Applied subjectively, the worldly objects cover our sense organs. Sense organs cover our mind. Mind covers our intellect. Intellect covers the reality. Behind the logic of cause and effect. Where is cause and effect? Is only in the intellect. And therefore, as I can see the mic, but the mic cannot see the eyes. Mind can know the condition of the eyes, but the eyes cannot see the mind. Consciousness can know the condition of the mind cannot know the consciousness. See, this mantra looks so big, but this is the secret behind it. And one by one the teacher has taken. First, antasharire nihito guhaya. Ajaha ekaha. Is not one per head. Bhagavan Krishna says, kshetradnyam chapi mam vidhi sarva kshetreshu bharata. Arjun, I alone am expressing through everything and being. Through the things I express as mere existence, and through the beings I express as, in addition to the existence, as Chetana or the life. The differences are not in me. The differences are on the conditioning through which I am expressing. See? Like electrical energy expressing through the bulb is light, through the fan is movement. There are not two types of electricities, only one. See, therefore, antasharire nihitum guhayam ajaha ekaha. But it is not possible for those who are lost in adidaivik. For them, the foundation in yoga, in sankhya, in karmakanda, in Buddhism, Jainism, and all religions, they always talk about one soul per body. And therefore, there can be varieties. See? But there is one reality expressing through all the bodies. Hold on to that truth. See? Like there is one space in all the houses. There is one air in all the living beings. There is one fire element in all the sentient beings. There is but one water in all the things and beings. There is but one prithvi in all the things and beings. There are not many. They appear many because of the conditioning. Like the example which I am repeating shamelessly. Like the man, he is a son, husband and a father. He has never become three. He is only one. This non-existing three, they are miserable. So what is happening? Antasharire पुत्रस्य अजो एकः नित्यं अस्य मनुष्य शरीरः यः सन अंतरे संचरन सन न वेद द सन डजंट नो दैट आई एम अ मैन फर्स्ट एंड देन द सन देन यहां हस्बैंड अंतरे संचरन हस्बैंड न वेद द हस्बैंड इज कवरिंग द मैन देन यहां फादर अंतरे संचरन फादर न वेद So are we talking about many or we are talking about one? See my friends. But what happens? One Dadaji, grandfather, told me, Swamiji, have you seen that Sri Krishna serial? I said, I have seen original. Why should I see the serial? No, what happens? When I see that Krishna on the screen, I am reminded of my grandson. What should happen? When you see that useless grandson, you should be reminded of Bhagavan Krishna. But it is the other way around. See, so much conditioned by the world or our experiences that the divinity that we are is hidden behind these conditioning. Therefore, you will understand the meaning of this mantra. So, antasharire niyato guhayam ajaha ekaha nityam is but one. And he alone is covered. Shariram means what? Shariram gruham uchyate. Sharira means that where somebody is living. So, what is the house of the space? This room is the house of the space. If there is no room, there cannot be house of the space. Space is houseless, homeless. Similarly, all the five great elements and thereafter all the contents of our personality, such as the body, the mind, the intellect, and ahankara, ahankaraha yasya shariram, and similarly, the chitta, avyakta, prakriti and akshara. Now these subtle points we will take in our next class before you disappear. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 हरिः ओम् श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम्